This is CBS 2 Eyewitness News 10 at 10. Watching out for you.
I think the awareness in the last couple of years of the overservice problem that we have had has made the servers a little more aware of, okay, we got to start cutting these people off.
And when it comes to too much alcohol, are servers responsible to make the call? Tough question tonight as Idaho lawmakers put state liquor laws under the microscope. Good evening, I'm Natalie Hirsch.
Thanks for joining us. I'm Mike Beard. You're watching 10 at 10 News and Weather in the first 10 minutes. Now, Idaho's longtime liquor laws could soon be changing.
Right now, lawmakers are looking at a bill that would shake up a number of things, including over-serving. And tonight, CBS 2 Eyewitness News clarifies what these changes could mean to you. Kirsten Thronson is live in Boise with more on tonight's big story.
Well, Mike and Natalie, as the downtown bars get ready for a big St. Paddy's Day celebration, lawmakers are getting ready to take a shot at this, a 66-page liquor law bill. In it, one of the topics, serving to people who are already drunk. Some want to change how bartenders tell who's drunk and who's not, and it comes down to one word. The signs are obvious to Susie Sturz.
You look for the way they walk, the way they talk, the way they, their mannerisms.
For the last 12 years, she's been training bartenders and servers on ways to avoid over-serving.
You look for signs of having trouble, say, lighting a cigarette, maybe taking their ID out of their wallets, speaking to people.
But now, Idaho lawmakers are looking to change the state's over-serving laws, which some say will actually make things clearer for everyone involved.
The word obviously is more constitutional, we believe, than the word apparently, which has had a lot of debate about it.
Right now, a bartender who sells or gives alcohol to a customer who is apparently intoxicated can be cited for a misdemeanor. But the change in the law would remove the word apparently and replace it with obviously.
From a trial point of view, from a criminal justice point of view, the word apparently has not been a successful standard in Idaho.
Creators of the bill say this will help make who should and shouldn't be served less subjective, but it puts more onus on bartenders to make that decision.
Whose responsibility do you think it is?
Do I think it is? I think it's the drinker's responsibility, but we're never going to make it that way.
And Sturz says if that won't happen, it's important to have laws on the book which are as clear as possible. Now, also included in this proposed bill would be mandatory bar training for all servers that come in contact with alcohol throughout Idaho, and that would be a certification process, basically. Actually, just recently, Boise City passed a city ordinance that requires all of its servers to go through this certification process. That's due by April 1st, but this bill would take it, of course, one step further and go statewide if it is approved. Reporting live in Boise, Kirsten Thronson, CBS 2 Eyewitness News.
And tonight I went the extra step to see what the penalties would be for someone serving what is being referred to as an obviously intoxicated person here in Idaho. Here's what I found in the proposed bill. It would still be classified as a misdemeanor, but the first offense would include a minimum fine between $500 and $1,000. It could also be punishable up to a year in jail. Now, for a second or subsequent conviction, the fine would increase to between $1,000 and $2,000 and would still include the possibility of up to a year in jail. Money from the fines would be put into a state fund for substance abuse treatments.